Hallelujah. 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 Are you ready to receive today? Hallelujah. Even on Christmas Day, you can receive something from the Lord. Amen. Even on Christmas Day, the power of God can be made manifest in your life. Hallelujah. So let's just make some declarations. Say, in the name of Jesus, I declare that which Jesus came to the earth for is made manifest in my life today. The anointing for the performance of it is made manifest in my life. In the name of Jesus. Can somebody shout amen? Amen? Okay, let's take our seats in the presence of the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Shekanama sofre beshiyabat. Hallelujah. Let's just turn our scriptures. I'm going to be sharing with you today on where is Christ's ministry today. Where is the ministry of Christ today? For he came from glory to birth something new upon the earth. He came to set men free. He came to bring liberty to all. And you and I are here because of the liberty that he brings. And today, his presence, today his power, today his glory shall be made manifest in our midst. For the word of God shall touch you, and the word of God shall illuminate you, and light and understanding will come to you. There are stages of Christ's ministry. There are stages of his manifestation upon the earth. Stage number one, let's look at the scripture. Hallelujah. Let's turn to, praise the Lord, book of Luke chapter 2, hallelujah, from verse 8. It says, and there were in the same country shepherds who were keeping the field, looking after their flock by night. And lo, the angels of the Lord came upon them. Hallelujah. And the glory of God shone round about them. Oh, you see that when the angels manifest, they come with what? The glory of heaven. Hallelujah. We have experienced that. And they were so afraid. And the angels said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you great tidings, good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And there shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. So the first manifestation of Christ, we see, is that he comes to the earth. But he comes to the earth and he comes like a baby. He's manifest like a baby. And the reason why he's manifest like a baby is because everything that God begins with a seed. But even though he's manifest like a baby, he still has the same mission. Are you with me? He still has the same mission. He is a baby, but he's still what? Christ, the Lord. The word Christ is a word that means the anointed one. The one that is anointed to set man free. So he came as the anointed one to set man free. And even though he was a baby, oh, he still had the same mission. So there are many of you here, you are still in your baby stage, but you still have a mission from God. So when God speaks to you, God will speak to you about the mission, but you look at yourself as a baby. But God is not looking at where you are. He's looking at what you're going to grow into. Are you hearing me? He's looking at what you're going to grow into. So Jesus was born, but the mission, he was born for that mission. He was born into that mission. And the mission was there, but yet unmanifested. Hallelujah. I said the vision was there, but yet what? Unmanifested. He was still Christ the anointed one. He was still what? Christ the anointed one. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. 10 years ago, 20 years ago, I was still the prophet of the Most High God sent to bring a visitation of the supernatural. Hallelujah. Even when I was not saved, hallelujah, I still had the same what? Mission. Oh, glory be to God. Let's look at the next stage of Christ's ministry. Hallelujah. Then Jesus, he did what? He grew. He developed. He went through his process. Because for you to become who God has called you to do, you're going to have to do what? Grow, develop, go through your process. Now, there are people who never get out of the babyhood stage. So because they never get out of the babyhood stage, the mission that they carry is what? Unmanifested. But they still have the mission. I said they still have the mission. And when they stand before God, he will speak to them about the mission. Because it's amazing that there was joy for a mission that was released into the earth, even though the mission was not manifested yet. Woo. Even though the mission had not come into manifestation, but there was rejoicing about the mission. Mm-mm-mm. And then we see the second stage of the mission. In the second stage, he begins to manifest phase one of the mission. I said what? Phase one of the mission. And phase one of the mission, he says, hallelujah, in the book of Matthew chapter 9. And he says, and Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. Hallelujah. And when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. So we see Jesus. We see he begins phase one. And in phase one, he is a man, a son of man, anointed by the Spirit. He is ministering as a prophet of God, and he's going from town to town. He's going to St. Lucia. He's going to Barbados. He's going to Trinidad. He has a traveling ministry, and he's going. He's having crusades. He's having conferences. He's going to synagogues. Sometimes the synagogues cannot hold him. He has outdoor crusade where thousands are packed, and he's going preaching the gospel of the kingdom. Hallelujah. And that's another phase. That's another phase. But still yet, he hasn't stepped into what? The ultimate phase. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So hallelujah. So there are people here today who you are no longer in your baby stage. I'm not in my baby stage. Hallelujah. I am not in my baby stage. Hallelujah. Oh, and so there are people who have begun to manifest that which God has called them to. They have begun to manifest the mission. Hallelujah. But I've come to prophesy to you that which you have seen so far, there is greater to come. I said there is greater to come. God never begins with the best first. That's why the Bible says that the path of the just is like a shining light that shines brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. Hallelujah. Whew. It's always greater with God. I said the future is always what? Greater with God. Because he saves the best wine for what? Last. Mm-mm-mm. Oh, let's go to the next scripture now. Next scripture. Hallelujah. Then we see him move into the second phase. We see him move what? Into the second phase. And now he's in the second phase. And we look at the scripture found in the book of Luke. And they found the stone rolled away, hallelujah, from the sepulchre. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord. And it came to pass that they were really perplexed. And behold, two angels, stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, and they said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but he's risen. Remember how he used to tell you when he was in Galilee, saying that the Son of Man shall be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified. And the third day he will be raised from the dead. Are you hearing what I'm preaching to you today? So what you got to understand is that he then moved into the second phase. And it was amazing that the second phase did not look like the first phase. In fact, if you looked at the second phase, you thought there was something wrong. But in the second phase, he had to go to the cross and take on the sin of humanity. Because in the second phase, he became the second Adam. Because the first Adam had actually done what? The first Adam had actually committed high treason. And he had given his birthright of the earth to the devil. And the second Adam, Jesus came as the second Adam to take back what Satan had stolen. And he had to do what? He had to be the sacrificial lamb. He had to take on the sin of mankind. The Bible says by one man sin entered into the earth, but by one man what? Righteousness entered into the earth. He had to give birth to a new race of people called the new creation, citizens of the kingdom of the Most High. So when he came, he had to do what? Pay the price. He had to suffer the judgment because sin had to be judged. And he came. That is why Hare Krishna cannot help you. That's why Muhammad cannot help you. There might be good people. They've said some really good things, some of them. But let me tell you this. Hallelujah. Let me tell you this. No one went to the cross for you. No one took your sin for you. No one went to hell for you. No one was raised from the dead for you. You got to understand the reason why you can escape hell is because he literally went to hell with your sin. When he went to the cross, he took the sin of mankind, past, present, and future. Are you hearing me? He took the sin of mankind, past, present, and future, and on that cross, he took it. And the Bible says that on the cross, when the sin of all of mankind, past, present, and future, rested upon him, that there was a darkness that covered the earth. There was a darkness that covered the earth. And the prophet Isaiah says something unusual. He says that the image of Jesus was more marred, was more contorted than any human being ever on the face of the earth. That means that was not produced by the beating of the Romans. That was produced by him becoming sin for mankind. Oh, that was produced. And the Bible says that there are people that saw him. And when they saw him, the Bible says that they said, God is judging him. Oh, but the book of Isaiah tells us what the real story is. Because Isaiah prophesying in Isaiah chapter 43, it says, he was esteemed, stricken by God. He said, people esteemed that God had struck him for something he had done wrong. But Isaiah says, no, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Bible says he went down into hell. And he was down into hell for 3 days. And when he was in hell, there was a battle. And he took the keys of death and Hades from the devil. He took the authority that Adam had given him. Hallelujah. And he was raised from the dead on the third day. That was the second phase of his ministry. Now Jesus is in the third phase. I said, Jesus is where? In the third phase. Because there's a third phase, and then there's a fourth phase. The first phase is when he's coming back as what? The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. That's why the Bible talks about the second coming of the Lord. He came the first time. He's going to come the second time. But that is for the future. What is he doing now? Mm-mm. What is he doing now? Let's turn to John chapter 14. Oh, hallelujah. John chapter 14, reading from Verse 12 to 13, it says, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. Before Jesus left, he gave us a clue as to what would happen in the third phase. He said, in the third phase, I am going to work through you. In the third phase, I'm going to manifest myself through you. You see, in the third phase, I want to do something that would make every devil tremble and flee. He said, the devil thought that he could defeat what I wanted to do because he only had one person to deal with. When Jesus was upon the earth, he was the only body of Christ. There was only one Christ on the earth. And if Christ was in Magazine Lane, in Bruce Alley preaching at the synagogue, there was no other manifestation of Christ anywhere else. But something was going to happen when he was raised from the dead on the day of Pentecost. Because on the day of Pentecost, he was going to create a body of Christ where men and women who received him will enter into his body and he will be multiplied all over the earth. So if the devil had to deal with him just one, they had to deal with Christ everywhere. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Now, the word Christ is not a surname. The word Christ is a title. It means the anointed one. So anywhere you see Christ in the Bible, you need to translate it, the anointed one and his anointing. Sometimes he's talking about the anointing, and sometimes he's talking about the anointed one. So when he says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me, he's saying, I can do all things through the anointing of the anointed one who strengthens me. I can do all things by what? That anointing. I can do all things by that anointing. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. And it was amazing what Jesus did. You see, because you need to understand that Satan did not see this. You need to grasp what Satan saw on the day of Pentecost. Because Satan was only fighting one man. But on the day of Pentecost, the Bible says, and suddenly there was a sound of a rushing mighty wind and the Holy Ghost power, the anointing of God, the same anointing that was on Jesus. The same anointing that caused him to do the things, to do the works that he could do. You see, the word works means product. He says, I want you to produce what I can produce. I want you to do what I can do. Are you here in church? He says, I am going to leave. But when I leave, hallelujah, the devil is going to have to deal with 1,000 of me. He's going to have to deal with 2,000 of me. He's going to have to deal with 10 million of me. He's going to have to deal with 100 million of me. So what is happening now? He is manifesting himself through men and women. That's why he comes to people and he calls them and says, I have an anointing for you. I'm going to put some of that anointing that was on me, I'm going to put it on you. I'm going to put some of that ability. I'm going to put some of that unction. I'm going to put some of that divine enablement on your life. Oh, hallelujah. And then Paul, the Apostle Paul, he had great insight into it. God called him. Jesus anointed him. Hallelujah. You see, you got to understand right now that we are the body of Christ. We are what? The body of Christ. Hallelujah. There was one body in Jerusalem. Now we are everywhere. I said, now we are everywhere. This was the strategy. You got to understand the God that you serve invented strategy. I said, the God that you serve invented strategy. Woo! Oh, hallelujah. Oh, now let's turn to this. Hallelujah. Oh, I love this scripture. In the book of Colossians, where is Jesus now? It says, wherefore Paul said, that's Colossians chapter 1, verse 25 and 26. It says, wherefore I am made a minister according to the dispensation or the administration of God which was given to me for you to fulfill the word of God. Even the mystery. The word mystery means it was a hidden secret. It was a mystery so that people could not see into it. See, there are certain things that God keeps what? mystery. He keeps it hidden so a devil cannot stop it, so an enemy cannot access it. Are you understanding that? Hallelujah. There are certain things about your life, it's a mystery, but it's a mystery for you. I said, it's a mystery for you. It's a mystery for you. It's a mystery for you to access. So what God was doing with Jesus was a mystery. It says, even the mystery which has been hid, hallelujah, from all generations, but now is made manifest unto the saints. So he hid it from Adam. He hid it from Enoch. He hid it from Jonah. He hid it from Ezekiel. He hid it from Isaiah. It was hidden from all those men. And it was also hidden from the devils. But it's now been made manifest unto the saints. What is this mystery? What is this mystery? What was this plan? What was the plan that was behind everything that he was doing? Oh, hallelujah. What was the plan? Hallelujah. It says, to whom God will make known what is the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is what? Christ in you, the hope of glory. It says, Christ in you, the hope of glory. He says, the mystery is this. That the anointing of God would come on the inside of you. The same anointing that was on Jesus that caused him to produce what he produced. The same anointing, not an inferior anointing, but the same anointing. That the same anointing will come on the inside of you. And because that same anointing will come on the inside of you, there is a vision that you will now start to have. Because the word hope is the word vision. The word hope is a clear mental portrait of a future you believe you can possess. So here you are. You are somebody. You are born on nobody's street. Are you with me? You are born in a family that has a curse. Are you with me? You are born with a bondage. You are born with a situation. But this is what happens. All of a sudden, you receive Jesus as the Lord and Savior of your life. And the anointing of God, the same ability that was in you, that was in Jesus, comes on the inside of you. All of a sudden, you understand, I am not the same. I've got some super that has come into my natural. All of a sudden, you realize, my God, I am just not me. This is Andre with the power of the Holy Ghost on Andre. This is Andre with the wisdom and the power of God on Andre. And all of a sudden, you realize, my God, I have a hope that the glory of God, I have a hope that the glory of God, that I will come out of hiding, that I will come out of obscurity. He didn't understand what glory means. Glory means the true essence. When they say she was singing in all her glory, that means the word glory means heavy. It means the heavyweight part of you. Are you understanding? The heavy part of you. Hallelujah. So when I was sitting down, I was not in my glory. I'm just manifesting a little right now. Hallelujah. So when I'm in my glory, I am preaching, I'm prophesying, I'm casting out devils, healing the sick. That's me in my what? Glory. So the Bible says that there are people who Satan had trapped their glory. Oh boy, can I preach to somebody here? There are people, Satan has stripped the glory from humanity. He has stripped the glory from humanity. There are people who will never rise. That's why, if you every year, I read the world's wealth report. And every year, the gap between the haves and the have-nots increases. You need to understand that there's 7 billion people on the earth today. Half of them, 50% of them, live on $1 a day or less. That's 3.5 billion people. 3.5 billion people are living in dirt poverty. Half of the earth. The only hope for them to come out of poverty is for the anointing to get in them and give them the dream, the vision of glory. Oh, hallelujah. Because they are not going. Listen, the system is stacked against them. I said the system is stacked against them. That is why there are people who sell their daughters They sell because the system is stacked against them. They cannot overcome the system. They cannot overcome the generational demons that are in their structure. They cannot overcome that. There is no hope. But I've come to tell you that Jesus Christ, He's anointing. He didn't just come to save us. He came to give us His anointing. And that anointing can get on the inside of you and become the hope of your glory. The hope of you coming from the back to the front. Oh, you want to understand glory? You study a man called David. David was what? In looking after what? The sheep. He was the forgotten one. He was at the back. He was at the back. When the prophet came to the house and said, the Lord has sent me to anoint somebody. Even his mom and dad, they thought there's no way possible that he could be one that is anointed. They brought the eldest one and went down, and the prophet said, no, it's not one of them. Here's the thing. His glory was hidden from them. I said his glory was hidden from them. Is there somebody here who nobody has seen your glory? But I've come to prophesy to you. I've come to bring understanding to you that you may have a dead-end job doing something that you are not born for. He was not born to look after the sheep in their house. Was the next king of Israel in their house. Was a giant slayer in their house. Was someone that would write the book of Psalms in their house, was someone that would bring lay the foundation for Jesus Christ to come in their house, was a prophet in their house, was a priest in their house, was a king, but his glory was hidden until the anointing found him. Oh boy, can I prophesy? I said until the anointing found him. Listen, David would have never risen in that family. Oh, Jesus. I said, David could have never risen. You got to understand that most of humanity is like David. Now, let me give you the stats. The other 40%, they don't make much money. The other 40% of the earth, in fact, you, right now, you are in the top, all of you here, in your state. Who thinks they're the brokers here? Look, who thinks, listen, nobody could be as more broke than me. Put your hand up. I'm just kidding. Who thinks like, okay, Sister Kathy, in her state, Sister Kathy has more resources, more money than 95% of the world. You need to understand that 95% of the world is broker than her. And if they look at her, they call her rich. Look at how she looks. They say, this is a millionaire. You know what I'm saying? You look at it, it's a millionaire. Because we live in a bubble, we don't fully grasp the world. Read the stats. Halababa shakatama. And then, do you know how many millionaires are in America? In America, there are less than 5,000 millionaires. So you think, they're not many. Yes, they're like, they're not many. I read these stats every year, the World Wealth Report, and I say, I am going to join the club. Hey, Jesus. I say, I'm joining the club. I say, how much is it to enter the top 1%? Last year, to enter the top 1% of the world, all you needed was $750,000 liquid that you can liquidate, and you're in the top 1% of the world. That is why some of you, when you come to God and you're not grateful, you just grumbling. I ain't got. Listen, you ain't got your dress. Jeez, man. Are you with me? Most of the earth compared to you, you're in the top 5% of the world. If you don't understand it, let's send you somewhere. You will come back different. I said, what? You come back different. You come back different. Most of the world is in serious diabolical bondage. That is why the earth is so corrupt. Here's why the earth is so corrupt. When you have 95% of the world broke, the rich can say, they can go to any place and say, for $100 US, come and work in this prostitution house. And women will give their daughters. It says, in fact, in Mongolia and Nepal, for 1,000 US, you can buy a virgin. And she'll work for you in your prostitution house. The mother will sell her. Because that 1,000 US dollars, that is more money than she'll see in a lifetime. So the reason why corruption and these evil things prevail on the earth is because the earth is dirt poor. Most of the earth is like David. Now, the rest of the 1%, they have $750,000 above. They're the people that have, they call the haves. They're the haves. Think about it, $750,000, that's not much to enter into the 1%. Then, to enter into the most elite group, which is the quantum millionaires, because that number of 1% is what they call HNBC, HNWI, high net worthy individuals. So to be a HNWI, you have to operate on $750,000 US. Now, to now go into the most elite club, which is 0.000%, you need 5 million. And if you enter the realm of 5 million, let me tell you, you control things. I said you control things. That means you're less than. That's why the report will come out and say 1% of the world owns what? 85% of the world. 1% of the world owns what? 85% of the world. And I'll end with this and end this part with this. The nation of India has 1 billion people. Over 1 billion people. 80% of the wealth in the country is controlled by 50-something families. So the rest of the 1 billion, they have to struggle with the 20% that's left. How are you going to rise? That is why, if they can, they leave the country, because they cannot manifest there. You know why Indians travel? And no chance for them to manifest. Oh, you know this. And that's why, when they leave, they work so hard. You know why? There is no chance for them to manifest there. No chance. Therefore, the only chance. Now, all those billions of people, they all have glory in them. But their glory will never come out except the anointing enters them. They can only manifest if the supernatural. Some say the supernatural. The supernatural has to enter into them. Hallelujah. For them to manifest. Otherwise, it is not happening. David could not manifest. The forces against him were too strong. He needed the anointing. So that is what Jesus is doing now. He's what? He's anointing people. I said he's anointing people. He's anointing people. That is why we as a people, we are going to rise by the supernatural. Oh, hallelujah. I said we're going to rise by the supernatural. I'm not going to rise by my certificate. Because let me tell you, in India, they have lots of certificates. One of the You can search it on the internet. The bondage is so bad in the second most populous country in the world that years ago, they have what's called the caste system. Years ago, they decided, the prime minister, because they're searching jobs, only go to people from certain castes. That's government jobs. And so the prime minister decided that he was going to break the caste system and allow people from all of India to apply for these jobs. The people within the caste system who had the privilege, they were so enraged that other people would have access to what they have only had, that they marched on the city, and one of them, in broad daylight, in front of the cameras, poured petrol on himself and set himself on fire. And he told the prime minister, if you dared not put the rule back, we'll burn the whole place down, and I'm the sacrifice. And the prime minister changed it, and they still have the caste system. Because he says, we will burn down the whole of India. That's, now, how, if you are a lower caste, how can you break that? The demon is too strong. The demon is too strong. The only way you can break that is the anointing. Jesus. Woo! Now, holy way. So I've got to tell you, be thankful this Christmas. I said, be thankful this Christmas. Most of the world cannot afford what you're wearing. 50% earn less either or a dollar a day. $1 a day. Hallelujah. That's why poverty is of the devil. Anybody who tells you that prosperity is wrong, they don't understand poverty. Think God wants you poor? Poverty is of the devil. It's why John said, I wish above all things that you what? Prosper. He says, God says, I look at the entire list, but I wish above what? All things that you prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospers. Now, what some of you don't know, that based on the world standards, you're rich. You see, based on the world standards, you're what? You're rich. See, you don't know. You're grumbling. Hallelujah. But today, gratitude is going to be birthed in this place. I said what? Gratitude is going to be birthed in this place. Hallelujah. And what Jesus did for you, you're going to receive. And what he's doing for you, we complain too much. You have access to stuff that folks don't have access to. Now, if you think about it, just think, there are over 200 and something countries in the world, and Barbados is listed about 37. If Barbados is so high, that should tell you how. Barbados is listed about 37 instead of standard of living. So if Barbados is 37, where are those who are 200? Nothing, you see, you're grumbling with your 37. You say, things are brown. We are 37. We are in the top of the list. Inside the top 50. Our standard of living. What about the ones that are 100? That should tell you how broke Earth is. And it's not that Earth does not have money. Because when they did the survey, if the wealth of the earth was divided evenly among everybody, everybody will have $10 million. And the entire 7 billion people can live in the state of Texas. And everybody have a 3-bedroom house, a townhouse. That's to tell you that the number of people living on the earth, for the earth, is very small. Everybody on the earth can live in the state of Texas. So the reason why earth is like this is because there's a devil. You heard what I said? Earth is like this because there's a what? There's a devil. But the anointing will make the devil get off your back. Let's stand up. Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And if you're like me, come January, first week in January, one of the first things I do, go on Google and check the World Wealth Report. Because every year, the gap is getting wider. Every year, more people are getting broker, and a few are getting what? Richer. Jesus. Now, the stat that really bothered me was this. I missed the figure, but a few hundred people who are the billionaires of the earth, they actually control most of the money on the earth, over 50%. Now, that does not mean you should grudge them, because here's the thing. You know that if you are going to rise, the system ain't going to make you rise. The system is only designed for a very few to rise, less than 1%. All the rest are under the system. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So if you think that the system in Barbados is designed for you to rise, you're mistaken. That's one thing the Rastas got right. Babylon systems. I'm a Buffalo soldier fighting for survival in Babylon. Let me tell you, it is definitely Babylon. Definitely. But here's the thing. You and I don't have to be Buffalo soldiers. We don't have to fight for survival, because we have what? Access to what? The supernatural. Hey, the what? Supernatural. We can access the anointing, which is the hope of glory. Jesus. My hope that I'll come out of this trial is the anointing. My hope, hallelujah. My hope that I will get a breakthrough, what? Is this anointing. Jesus. If you're here today, let's close our eyes. If you're here today, you heard me preaching this, and said, "My God, I didn't know the word was like this. I didn't know earth was like this." Shakataba. Everyone close your eyes. Shavadabasa. You heard me preach. If you're here today and you say, "I need this anointing. I need to make this Jesus the Lord of my life. I need to have this anointing come into my life. I need to have this Holy Spirit come into my life like this preacher is preaching about, like this prophet is prophesying about. I need this." Lo braba shaka. If you do so, hallelujah. If you want this, then lift your hands up. 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 Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Then I want you to pray this after me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say, "Lord Jesus, I now understand what you did for me. And I now understand what you are able to do for me now. What you did for me on the cross was to take care of my sin problem. Was to take care of the curse problem. But what you're doing for me right now is that you are available to anoint me so that the system will not keep my glory in bondage. So that the system would not control my destiny. Oh, how I appreciate you today. Oh, how I'm thankful that you came today. My. So right now, Jesus, I confess before heaven, before earth, and under the earth, you are my Lord. You are my Savior. I receive you into my life in the name of Jesus. I receive you into my life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody shout glory.